Hello everybody, this is going to be an unboxing of the Nintendo Switch, which I have been wanting to get since it was announced, but the steep price tag of $400 Canadian was just, I couldn't do it. But for this week I was looking online and EB Games, or GameStop for my viewers in the States, had a deal where you could trade in a newer console to get $150 off the Switch. Now, for me, that would be the new 3DS, which, to be honest, I've only used like 10 times probably since I got it, which was back in when it came out, like 2 years ago. So I figured I might as well use it. And I still have my old 3DS and my 2DS, so I don't really need it. There's only a few games that actually utilize the new 3DS power, and I actually. There's another thing I did with that, so I don't have those games either. So, anyways, let's get into this. Oh boy. Oh, have I left it down? Probably. Let's try this. Yeah, okay. Alright. So, there is the console itself, the Joy-Cons. Nice look at these. You know, they feel heavier than people are letting on. They don't really feel that light. I was worried. And yeah, I got the gray version. They didn't have the color one. Actually, I was kind of worried because I phoned the store at last night actually, and they said they were getting more in today, and they open at 9:30. So I got there at 9:30, and there were already like three or four people buying the Switches already. And I was like, oh crap! I've already out of luck because I know it's a short supplied console. But they still had the gray one, which I really don't care. You'll see why soon. And thankfully, like I said, they had them, and the red ones were actually the first ones to go. I think people like the colored ones better, which is fine. I don't have a problem with the colored. I mean, either way would be good for me, but get rid of all this cardboard here. And then we have the HDMI cable, which is good. And I assume this is the main body of the controller, which I'll be honest, I'm probably gonna use this in a portable mode more than anything. But yeah, that's the controller. It does look good. I might try it on the console, but I don't really need to. I personally like portable systems. And I think that's pretty much it. We got the power cord. Nope. Oh, these are the end pieces, which I know that some people have put them on the wrong way. There's a certain way it has to go. You have to match the minus and plus together. And some people have put them on the wrong way, and then they have to freaking fight with them to get them off. There's the power bar. Freaking brick. Really? Fine. Whatever. I have an extra space on my power bar. I'll be fine. There's the other one. And then just the instructions and crap like that. Alright, so the console, the main console here, looks pretty nice. It's actually pretty heavy, all things considered. Got a little kickstand there. I'm sure you've all seen this 100 times already. I mean, I have personally. Because I really want to see it. I really want to play it. Now, the other thing is, we had another deal with new games and pre-ordered games. If you trade in 3 games that were on their long list they have on the website, you could get a free new game. And so I had Xenoblade Chronicles, which would only work with the new 3DS, so I don't need it. And I got bored with it, like really, really early in. Then I had what was it called? Animal Crossing, like Home Life or something like that, Happy Home, which I only got on Amazon for like $10 on Black Friday, so I used that too. And LBX Little Battlers, which I'll be honest, I might have kept playing it if it didn't keep me reminding me of SDGO, SD Gundam Capsule Fighter, and how it's not there anymore, and I can probably play that. So I use those three, and I got Mario Kart 8 Deluxe for nothing. Cost me nothing. It was free. So yeah, I got the console for $250, and the game for nothing. And then I put an extra $50 on for a year extra year warranty, because I always like to do that if I'm spending over $100 on a console. But then I also decided to get this, the starter kit, which basically has a screen protector. It has these colored parts to go over the, I've already spaced all the name. Holy crap. That's pretty bad. But on the end controllers, and so now they're different colors. And it comes with a case. I actually was going to get the case. It was $24. No, it was $22 for the actual case by itself. And then $10 for the screen protector. Then I saw this. And it even has earbuds. So all that for $29. Much better. So, that is it. That is the Nintendo Switch. I still want to get Breath of the Wild, but the thing is, it had to be a new game, like the last 2 weeks, and Breath of the Wild came out in March, so I'll have of this until I save enough money to get the Zelda game. So that is about it. I'm going to get this thing all hooked up, and I'll see you in the next review.